For the third time this season, Edmond Memorial and Midwest City met on the basketball court. As the Bulldogs had won the first two meetings, but the way Midwest City started this contest, it looked like the third time might be the charm for the Bombers. Greg Austin had the steal and scoop layup, and then freshman Omega Harris forced the turnover that led to Cortrez Colbert's bucket on the other end. Trez had 12 points for the Bombers. Memorial's Obi Omegano was perfect on both of his three-point shots, but Shane Coward's team trailed the entire first half. UCO signee Jared Job had 9 points and countless hustle plays for the Bulldogs. And when James Woodard hit the three-pointer, Memorial had a lead that they would never lose. Woodard finished the night with 15 points and 14 rebounds. Western Illinois signee Obi Omegano had a game-high 17 points, but Dwayne Bradley's boys continued to battle. TJ Noel hit 3 three-pointers for the Bombers. That one cut Memorial's lead to 3 starting the fourth quarter. The final period, however, was all Bulldogs. Jordan Woodard hit the floater in the lane as Edmond Memorial wins their second state title, while Midwest City will have to settle for silver for the second straight season.
Well, you know, it's been a long time since we brought Louise back home. I think it was 93, the year I was born. And coaches know we had the talent, the personnel to do it this year. So we just worked hard every day, day in and day out, to get here. We work hard every day, break on goal ball every day, you know, to come out and get one goal.
I just know that I'm so proud of our young men. They're such great kids, such great, great kids. Great credit and great respect to the Midwest City Bombers. They're a quality basketball program. Our kids, when they got the nerves settled, they got back to playing winning basketball. That's getting stops and rebounds. You know, it's a great privilege to be able to work with such great kids. I couldn't be happier for them. They set out to attain a goal. They worked hard. Things fell into place. We're very fortunate. I'm just glad they had that opportunity.
Edmond Santa Fe coach Paul Bass had been waiting for this matchup all season. His second-ranked Lady Wolves playing top-ranked and undefeated Midwest City. The Lady Bombers' Adriana White hit the slick reverse layup, and then Ashley Clark had what looked like the exact same shot. Clark led the Lady Bombers with 14 points, as Art Bodie's team was trying to win their 51st straight game. But they were shorthanded, as talented senior Marisha Wallace suffered a knee injury in the semifinals and had to sit out of Saturday's game. Santa Fe's Daisha Gonzak got 2 off transition, and then Tori Lanier had the assist to Courtney Walker for the slick bucket and foul. The Texas A&M commit had a game-high 19 points. Tamara Lee had the steal and layup as the speedy freshman helped Santa Fe to a huge fourth quarter, where they outscored Midwest City 24-7. Walker then had the pass ahead to Lee for another layup, as the Lady Bombers' dominance comes to an end. Edmond Santa Fe is the new queen of Class 6A as they finish the season with a 27-1 record.
We wanted to get a quick start. We've been doing that. We haven't been doing that all season. So when we did, we just wanted to keep it and, you know, not let them come back. It's great. We work so hard, you know, all the time. We're just trying to come out and work hard for it.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Great, great high right here. Didn't think it'd ever happen. I've been doing it for 15 years, and it finally has happened. They work hard. We go deep. We're a speedy team. We love to attack and play great defense. And today we beat a great team that hadn't lost a game. Just unbelievable.